Hi guys, Charles here with Be About Boxing. Today I want to talk about how to see the punches coming, or how not to get hit by those punches. Okay, so when you're in your fighting stand this way, and you're looking at your opponent, what you're looking at now, what you see, this is what you see. You see that? You're looking right at it, right? What you want to do is you want to move your head. Not vigorously, you can do all of this, but just a little bit. Here. And the reason why is so that you can get a different angle, a different view of those punches coming at you, right? Because when you're staring right at them, it's hard to tell that punch is coming right at you, right? Now, imagine if you stood on the side of the opponent watching, you could see this, right? No matter how fast I would move, you would always see that coming, okay? So that's what you want to give yourself. And you give yourself that by doing this little movement here. So here, I'm not looking directly at his gloves coming at me. I'm looking at him from an angle. Over here, look at him from an angle over here. Even with my footwork, if I step back this way a little bit, I look over a different angle. Or if I step back and lower my weight, I'm looking at the punch from a different angle because I'm looking up at him. Or if I go up tall this way, I'm looking down at his glove, giving myself an advantage because I can see the punch is coming. I wonder why Mike Tyson always did this? It wasn't just to create a moving target, although that is part of it. But the other thing is that when he moved this way, he could see the punches. He could see his opponent's hands coming out. And as the opponent's trying to punch down, he would catch him with a body shot, a hook, or he would just step off over this way and catch him with one of those. Okay, so practice that. Now, with your back foot, you can do a lot just by stepping over. Step over this way, I look, I get right back on that line. Then I step back, I get right back on the line. And I haven't really moved the front foot, just the back foot here. And back online, offline, online. Step back, drag a little bit. And step back this way with your chin up. That is a good way to get knocked out. Keep the chin down, keep the shoulder up this way, and move from here, right? And so, just remember that. If you have a fighter in front of you that's particularly fast with his hands, or he's non-telegraphic, meaning that he doesn't use this motion when he punches, because a lot of fighters, they do that. I do that when I want to trick my opponent. So you want to get that little look in here, moving here. You have to do a whole lot, right? Even Muhammad Ali, when he did this, when he bounced around like that, he was able to see the opponent's punches coming. And so he can move out of the way just a little bit. Just out of the way, just a little bit. Over his head, under, he can just move back like that. Okay, so just practice that. And you can get a ball tied to the ceiling or to the door frame, a tennis ball on a string and swing it and practice your head movement. Mm-hmm. Get off that line, right? That way, moving. Okay? All right, thanks for stopping by. And remember, be about boxing.